Hello friends, in this video I'm going to we will study about equivalence of Kalin Clegg statement and Clausius statement. If you have not seen my videos on Kalin Clegg statement and Clausius statement, please make sure that you are watching this video only by seeing that video, then you will be getting a brief first understanding. So the main question is how to prove the equivalence of this both statement. So so what we do here, we will violate one statement and then we prove that violation of the one statement make the other statement to get violated. So this can be proved by violating Kalin-Clegg statement and second by violating Clausius statement. So at first we are violating the Kalin-Clegg statement and we will prove that violation of this Kalin-Clegg statement makes the violation of the Clausius statement too. So for that, let us assume there is a device which works between if suppose this is high temperature and this is low temperature reservoir and there is a heat engine which works W and which takes QH amount of say Q1 amount of heat. Yeah? So in this case we are violating the Kalin-Clegg statement by assuming that it is possible to make a device which works in a cycle and delivers a net amount of work to the surrounding and takes Q1 heat from the reservoir, from the only single reservoir. Now to prove, let us assume that there is another reservoir that transfer heat from low temperature reservoir to high temperature reservoir by taking this this work. So in this case the Kalin-Clegg statement gets violated, but here Clausius statement remains unviolated. Means Clausius statement is does not violate here, it is valid here. Now if we combine the both device, we get this high temperature and this low temperature. Okay. This is the device. If we say 1, if we say 2, this is 2 and it is taking heat QL and this device 1 and it is delivering work W here and this is the heat. So this is Q1 and this is Q2. QH, this is QH, and this is QL. If we say QL, that is equals to QH minus Q1. So if you take this device as a combined device, we are seeing that the net effect of this device is to transfer heat from low temperature body to higher temperature body, and it produces no other effect. Here in this case, it violates the Clausius statement. Here we are saying that here in case first, if we assume case first and this case second, here we are seeing that we are violating the Kelvin-Black statement and saying that it is possible to form a device which delivers work to the surrounding by accepting heat from a single reservoir, and another device which transfer heat from low temperature body to high temperature body. So here we are violating the Kelvin-Black statement, and Clausius statement is still valid here. But if we combine the both device, the Clausius statement get also violated. So we can say that violating Kelvin-Planck statement here, in this case we are violating Kelvin-Planck's, and here Clausius statement gets violated on combining. So we have done by first method that if we violate the Kelvin-Planck statement, then our Clausius statement get also violated. So now we will solve this by case second. So what we will do here, let us suppose there is a device that produces no effect other than transferring a heat from low temperature body to higher temperature body. This is low temperature and this is high temperature. Okay, and this is device 1, this is taking Q1 and this is Q1. Here what we are doing, violating Clausius statement. In this case, we are violating Clausius statement by making a device which transfer heat from low temperature body to higher temperature body without producing any other effect. Now for this two, let us assume this another reservoir, another device 2, that takes heat from high temperature reservoir and rejects to low temperature reservoir and does a work W is equals to QH minus Q1. Okay, in this case we are violating the Clausius statement, but in this device the Kelvin-Planck statement is still not violated and it is valid. Kelvin-Planck statement is valid here. In case A, Kelvin-Planck statement is valid. Now if we combine these two devices, if we combine device 1 and device 2, we will get this type of structure. This is high temperature body and this is low temperature body. Now if we assume this device to be device 2 and the work that it will be getting QH minus Q1, this is Q1 and this is the device 1, this is Q1 and now if we assume this is Q1, this is QH and this is QL is equals to QH minus Q1. Okay, if we combine this device we will getting this structure, we will be getting this structure, and in this case what we are getting a device that produces, that delivers a work W to the surrounding and takes heat, sorry this sign is like this, and takes heat from the single reservoir. This is the single reservoir which this device is taking heat and delivering a net amount of work QH minus Q1. So it violates the Kelvin Planck statement here. It's violating Kelvin Planck statement. Why? Because it is of type PMM2. It is accepting heat from high temperature body only in the form of QH minus Q1 and delivering total QH minus Q1 to the surrounding. And we have read earlier in Kelvin Planck statement is that it is impossible for a device to convert all the heat which is receiving it from a reservoir into work. Here it is receiving QH minus Q1 amount of heat and it is delivering QH minus Q1 amount of work to the surrounding. So it is, this case is not possible, means it is violating the Kelvin Planck statement. What we have done here, we have violates the Clausius statement in this device, and we make Kelvin Planck statement valid here. But if we combine the both device, we are finding that the Kelvin Planck statement get also violated. So from both the cases, if we conclude a statement that we have made Kelvin Planck statement invalid here, then here we are getting Clausius statement get also violated, and in the second case we have violated the Clausius statement here, and we have found that Kelvin Planck statement get also violated while combining the whole device. So this violation of each statement makes the violation of the other statement. So we can say that from these two statements, we can say that the violation of one statement makes violation of the other. It means they are equivalent to each other. Hence, this second law of Kelvin Planck statement and Clausius statement are totally equivalent.